All right, everybody, thanks for joining me in this demo. It's time to go ahead and create your first Azure subscription. Now, to follow along, you are going to need a few different details, such as a Microsoft account, whether that's at outlook.com or at hotmail.com or something similar. And you'll also need a credit card and your address details as well. What we're going to do within this demonstration is go to the azure.microsoft.com website, and we're going to go ahead and create a free Azure subscription. Now, just remember, like we spoke of within the lesson, if you are a student, you won't need a credit card. And what you can actually do is sign up for a student subscription instead. Whichever choice you choose, I'm going to include links for these options in the description of this video. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and click on Try Azure for Free. And then you'll see we have the two options, Start for Free or Pay as you Go. With the Start for Free option, like we spoke of within the lesson, you'll see we get access to a range of different free credits and services, all for up to 12 months. So what I'm going to do is click on the Start Free option. And then you'll see the first step is I need to go ahead and sign in with a Microsoft address. Now, I will also just call out what we're going to be doing within these next few steps is setting up a new Azure subscription and a brand new Azure AD tenant. So like I spoke of within the previous Azure AD demonstration, if you do already have your own Azure AD tenant, then what you actually want to do is open up a different tab, navigate to portal.azure.com, and go ahead and log in with the administrator account from your Azure AD tenant. Then you can just go ahead and create a new subscription through the portal. However, for this demonstration, we're going to create a brand new free trial. So I'll close that tab down. And what I'm going to do is log in with my Microsoft account here, jl.cloudlee@outlook.com. Now, I don't really monitor this email, so if you do have any queries, please don't send it to that address and instead use the usual contact channels. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and authenticate. I'll pause the video and I'll be back shortly once that's ready to go. Okay, fantastic. You'll see I'm logged in using my account, and now we're going through the creation of an Azure free account using this wizard here. Now, do just bear in mind again that this address is what's going to be used for the creation of my Azure AD tenant. If you do want to have something different for your Azure AD tenant, then it's probably best to go back and create a free Microsoft 365 account and set up your tenant that way. However, for this demonstration, that's perfectly okay. So I'm going to go ahead, type in my first name. I'll type in my last name. And then you'll see if I scroll down here, there's a range of other details I need to type in as well. So I will need a valid mobile number or phone number that can be used for this verification of my identity. If you were to be creating a subscription that would be used by a company, then depending on your location, you may need to provide some additional company details here as well. And you'll also see as part of this, I do need to fill in some details about my address. Okay, and then I can choose what sort of communication preferences I do want from Microsoft. So what I will do is I'll go ahead and fill out all of these details using my own personal address, phone number, and so on. I'll pause the video once that's underway, and I'll be back shortly once we're ready for the next step. Okay, so I've gone ahead and filled in the details. I've verified my number, entered in my address, and I've clicked on the next button. You'll see now what we need to do is provide the credit card details that will be used for the subscription. Now, what you'll see here is that this is for a temporary verification of the credit card, but you won't actually be charged unless you move to that pay-as-you-go normal subscription. So whilst we continue to use the free subscription, we can continue to use the credits and the free services that have been provided for us. So once again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to enter in all of my details for the credit card, the matched billing address, and then I'll click on the sign up option, and I'll be back shortly once that's ready to go. All right, fantastic. So after entering in those credit card details and clicking on the sign up option, you'll see that everything was verified, hopefully. And if that's the case, you should see a page that looks like this, where you're ready to get started. Now, what you can do is simply go ahead and click on the Go to Azure Portal, and that's going to an address that you'll be using really commonly, portal.azure.com. So straight away, you'll be navigated into the Quick Start Center, where you can see a range of different guided steps for getting started with different services like virtual machines, containers, databases, and much more. Now, I don't actually want to do this, so what I want to do is take you back to the Home window by clicking on Home, and you'll see we've got access to the Azure portal, just like we spoke about within the lesson on management tools. So if I wanted to, I could go ahead, click on the menu on the left-hand side, get access to a range of different common services. If I wanted to, I could change these services around, drag them to suit my requirements, or even pin other services to this menu. What I can also do is choose to use the search menu up the top. For example, I could go to virtual machines. Okay, I could go ahead and click on that option. And I will just quickly call out that it is really quite common to see this error message when you do first get started. Don't be too scared about that. It's just because your Azure AD tenant and portal relationship might still be being synchronized and configured on Microsoft's platform. So if that does actually happen to you, you can go ahead and wait a little bit of time and then fully refresh the page and it should come good. So that's actually what I'm going to do. I'm going to wait a couple of minutes and I'll refresh this page and I'll show you some other things. Excellent. After waiting a little bit of time and fully refreshing that page, the error has gone. So we'll see here that I've got access to the menu, the search bar, and the recently accessed resources once we have those as well. Now, really importantly, what I do want to call out is that of the subscription. So if we click on subscriptions here, you'll see we've got the brand new subscription that you just created. And since you created that, you will have the role of owner. Now, talking about the different roles and access control for Azure subscription is outside the scope of this course, but just understand this means you have full, unfettered access to all of the resources, everything that you create within this subscription because you created it. Now, if you had actually already gone ahead and logged into the Azure portal using an Azure AD tenant that you've created earlier, what you could choose to do is just click on the plus option here and create a new subscription this way. So you can actually go ahead, create as many subscriptions as you like and link that back to your AD tenant. So also let's browse back to home on the left-hand side. What I'm then going to do is click on the menu once again, and I'll go ahead and browse down to Azure Active Directory. And really importantly, you'll note here that this is the Azure AD tenant that has been created for me through the wizard where I created the Azure free subscription. So that's why you can see here, I've got the primary domain looking a little bit funny. The Microsoft wizard has just used my email address to go and create that Azure AD tenant for me, and you can't actually change this primary domain. So that really shouldn't matter to you if this is just a demonstration subscription that you're playing around with and learning how Azure works, but if this was a production subscription, then maybe you wouldn't be happy with that. And in fact, I have seen some scenarios where organizations have set up their environment like this, and the Azure AD tenant has had the primary name matching that of the IT technician who set this up for their environment first. So just do be careful about that if this is a production subscription. All right, so the last thing to just be aware of is that if we actually browse back to home once again and take a look at subscriptions, we open up our existing subscription. I'm just going to collapse that on the left-hand side. You'll see we can get some information here about the top free services that have been used within your subscription. You can also note at the top here in the overview that I have the remaining amount of free credits and they do expire in 30 days. Now, once these 30 days have elapsed, Microsoft will provide you the option to upgrade to a pay-as-you-go subscription if that's what you'd like to do. Or we could click on that right now and upgrade straight away. Also, if we go ahead to the search bar and type in free for free services, click on the free services option there, you can get more information about the free services that Microsoft includes for the entire 12 months of your Azure free account. Okay, everybody, so that's a quick introduction to getting your Azure subscription up and running. We've now got everything that we need to go ahead and learn about how to create a range of different services in Azure. So thanks for joining me in this demo. I'll see you again shortly, where we're going to take a look at setting up a budget for your subscription.